Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to viewers of Sky Sports Friday Fight Night. This is the main event of the evening, the British and Commonwealth Light Heavyweight Championship. Please welcome into the ring the challenger, Courtney Fry.
Well, not so much the last chance saloon for Courtney Fry, but maybe the last drink in it. He was a very, very good amateur. Hasn't quite worked out for him as a professional. Too inactive, few cuts problems, setbacks at the wrong time. He's 34 now. He has to do it tonight.
Yeah, but I would imagine this is the only chance he'll get to do it. He has had a strange career. 6 years a pro, and in 3 of those years he only managed one fight. I don't know the reason for that, but I would say he's definitely the smartest boxer that Cleverley will have faced. But he's never really, his career hasn't caught fire, and I think he's going to pay the penalty for that night. Cleverley's quite the opposite, he's really on a roll. And I think this is a massive task tonight for Courtney Fry. He's good enough, his talent has never been in question, but I think this will just be too tough for him.
Looks ready, doesn't he, Courtney Fry?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the ring the British and Commonwealth Light Heavyweight Champion, Nathan Cleverley.
Well, this is a remarkable story, really. A young man who's just started the final year of a maths degree at Cardiff University. But not only has he been crunching numbers, he's been crunching opponents as well lately. Stopped his last four. He's really exploded as a major talent in this country over the last year. It was a year ago this weekend that he beat the very, very durable and highly respected Tony Oakey in a Commonwealth Light Heavyweight Championship fight. This is his sixth title fight in the last 12 months. Likeable, articulate, and genuinely and potentially a world-class light heavyweight. Here's the tale of the tape for the fight tonight. Cleverley is 12 years younger and fresher too, you'd think. Courtney Fry and Cleverley about the same height. Fry a little bit light at 12 stone 4 pounds and 5 ounces. Slight reach advantage for Cleverley, nothing much. Fry made his debut back in 2003, but look at that. He's only had 15 fights in 6 years. Too inactive, really. Cleverley's been on the go at championship level for the last year, as we've been telling you, and he's starting to stop more opponents significantly. He's 12-1 on to win this, Nathan Cleverley. Fry may feel the 11-2 against him is a bit of an insult. Maybe he'll have something to say about that in the next hour here.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the famous York Hall in Bethnal Green, East London, for tonight's main event. Frank Warren, in association with frankwarren.tv and the Queensbury Fight Network, proudly present 12 rounds each of 3 minutes duration for the Light Heavyweight Championship of Great Britain and the Commonwealth, live and exclusive on Friday Fight Night, right here on Sky Sports. Your officials are appointed by the Commonwealth Boxing Council and the British Boxing Board of Control, and your three judges at ringside are Mr. Mark Green of Romford, Mr. Ian John Lewis of Gillingham, Mr. Dave Paris of Leeds. Your steward in charge is Mr. Dave Wilson, and when the action begins, your referee of the contest is Mr. Victor Loughlin of Paisley, Scotland. Your timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Bob Edgeworth. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, the challenger, fighting out of the red corner. He enters the ring with a record of 13 wins, 2 losses, with 5 of those wins coming by stoppage. at yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 12 stone, 4 pounds, 5 ounces. Tonight, he's wearing the blue shorts. Please welcome from Wood Green, London, England, the 1998 Commonwealth Games champion and the 3 times ABA champion and tonight's challenger for the title, Courtney Frye. And across the ring this evening, he enters the ring with an unbeaten record of 17 wins, with 7 of those wins coming inside the distance. Weighing in, 12 stone, 6 pounds, 5 ounces, wearing the yellow and black shorts, fighting out of the blue corner from the Cefn Forest in South Wales. Please welcome, making the 4th defence of his Commonwealth title and the 1st defence of the British title, introducing the reigning British and Commonwealth light heavyweight champion, Nathan Cleverly. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Okay guys, you've had your instructions in the dressing room. Remember, obey my commands at all time, defend yourselves at all time. God bless, let's do it, touch them.
Ready to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, 12 3-minute rounds for the light heavyweight championship of Great Britain and the Commonwealth.
Massive night this for Courtney Frye. Where does he go if he loses this one? Has to make all that amateur pedigree pay off in the professional ranks tonight. But Cleverly is really on a roll, only missed out by one vote in the voting for this year's Young Boxer of the Year. Cal Brook winning that award. It was a very close run thing. Cleverly has looked really, really good and very fast and increasingly powerful in recent contests. He's in the gold and black trunks here. Lands with a right hand there. Frye wants to concentrate, he says, on his boxing tonight, but he has to keep Cleverly away from him.
See, this is a tough job for Frye because I don't think he has the edge in any aspect of the game over Cleverly. So you wonder how he's going to find victory. He's smart, he's cagey, tremendous amateur pedigree, but his pro career, he's never got the chance to show how good he can be, whereas Cleverly's on a roll and he's on a high.
Cleverly's been particularly dangerous with his body punching over the last year or so. Sparred about 150 rounds with Joe Calzaghe as he was coming through, and it hasn't done him any harm by the look of things. Fast start here from Cleverly, looking to impose himself straight away. Young, full of belief, and how much real confidence is there with Frye at this stage of the game, you wonder. We'll see tonight.
Yeah, well, watching Cleverly, you're looking for weaknesses. He's only 22, he doesn't have the experience, but I can't see any weaknesses. Nice uppercut from Frye. He's going to have to get the punches off a little bit quicker. He's going to have to dampen some of the enthusiasm that Cleverly's brought into the ring here.
Frye's watched a lot of Cleverly in action. Says he's seen one or two weaknesses, thinks he's a little open, and maybe one of the punches he rather likes, having watched the tapes, is the uppercut. He's tried it about 4 times already.
Well, thinking fighters like Frye, if they can take a round or so to get themselves warmed up, you know, and warm himself into a fight. So maybe he was expecting in the opening round he wouldn't make any great impact, and he's been caught on the hop a little bit. But no, nothing untoward has happened. Some good punches been thrown by Cleverly, a lot of them blocked. So maybe Frye won't be too upset about losing the opening round if this continues.
Frye's trying to establish his jab as well, just to stop Cleverly having everything his own way on the outside. And once or twice that has worked for him as well.
Well, Frye, to his credit, he's been outworked in the opening round, but he's come back with some decent counters of his own, accurate with the uppercut, as you've said. So he's shown he certainly deserves a crack at the titles here, and he's going to give it his best shot.
Had his successes, but it's been mostly Cleverly in this opening round. He is rampant at the moment, and somehow Frye has to dent that ring of confidence he has about him.
He's maybe just a little bit over-enthusiastic in the opening round, cleverly.
And you are beaten into the jab, right? You are beaten into the jab, right?
Welcome back to a very atmospheric York Hall, Bethnal Green. Hot prospect. Well, champion now, Nathan Cleverley in action here with Courtney Fye.
Yeah, a good start from Cleverley. Fry's a thinking fighter. He looks for time to perform. Cleverley not giving them that time.
Good success rate for Cleverley in the first round there, 40%. They're asking him to be a little more authoritative with his own jab, Cleverley, in the corner. He's trained by his father, Vince. Shades of Joe Calzaghe about that as well. He even spars with his dad. That is unusual. Worth remembering that Courtney Fry was good enough to win a Commonwealth Games gold medal, 3 ABA titles, and reach a European Championships final as an amateur. Good body shot there, Cleverley. Those are trademark punches from him. He's at Fry here.
Well, signs that De Fry's jab could give him some problems. I mean, I do reckon that Fry is the cagiest, the cutest opponent that Cleverley has faced. So the battle of the jabs could be important. And will Cleverley try to cancel out the jab by getting inside it as opposed to jabbing with Fry?
Cleverley acquired the British title against Danny McIntosh, stopping him in seven rounds, and had McIntosh down four times in that. That was to add to the Commonwealth ground he'd already collected. Both of those titles at stake here. Heads nearly clashed.
Cleverley's leaping in with his punches now and again. I think that's because of the jab of Fry, so we have to be careful of heads coming together.
Good jab from Cleverley. Very anxious to impose himself here, just as you'd expect.
Yeah, but he's been made to miss a few times. So I don't think maybe it has the accuracy in this round that he expected. Yep, he's missing with quite a few punches. Fry, cute with the counters.
It's always just the danger for Cleverley that he starts to believe his own publicity a little bit. Fry, I think, believes that some of those wins he's been having have been on the soft side, some of the Commonwealth ones anyway. Certainly couldn't decry the victory he had over Tony Oakey. That was an outstanding victory, really, over a normally very tough to beat opponent. That's a great right hand from Cleverley that time.
Boxing well, Cleverley, but struggling now and again to pin Fry down. I think just Fry is just showing how much he's learned in that amateur career. Can't match Cleverley for speed.
Boxing quite cutely, Courtney Fry. Hard to stay with the work rate of Cleverley, though. Cleverley by name, and obviously Cleverley by nature as well, this fella. Welcome back. Well, Nathan Cleverley loves the body attack, and there you can see how he succeeded with that so far.
Yeah, but I don't think he's finding it just as easy to find the target as he expected. Fry is cute, good defence, reflexes are good, but certainly the initiative is with Cleverley.
Champion Nathan Cleverley from Cefn Forest in Wales in the yellow and black here. And Courtney Fry, hard to believe he's 34 years of age now. Just the suspicion that did he turn pro a little too late to be effective? Well, he could disprove that theory with a win here. It would be an upset win, there's no doubt about that.
See, Cleverley's not landing cleanly, and he's not used to that. He's used to being much quicker than his opposition, landing good powerful shots where you can put them together. But when the first leading punch doesn't land, then you can't get the combinations off. I think this is a lot trickier than he expected.
Good jabs there.
Good jabs there.
Yeah. One, two, three of them. That was better from Cleverley. They had a bit of authority about them as well, and Fry's just pouring with his. There's a right to the body too, going in from Cleverley, and these will have a cumulative effect if he keeps landing them.
And I think the double jab would work, because the Fry is just pulling his chin back from the first one, but the double jab, follow it in, the second one would land. The Fry really boxing well. He's forced onto the defensive, but he's boxing well.
This is his first 12 rounder, Courtney Fry. Body shot from Cleverley.
Cleverley's blasting as opposed to using the skills that we know he possesses. I wonder maybe if he just, he's too intent to be in a crowd. That's a good right hand, that one, trouble Fry.
It did. He was a bit dazed from that. He's holding on, Fry, trying to buy a bit of time. Threw out some leather afterwards, but he certainly just wilted a bit when that one went in, and Cleverley will have noted that all right. And there's another fierce looking left hand which landed somewhere around the border.
Well, just maybe at a time when Fry was beginning to find a bit of confidence, because he was boxing well, that's really shaking him up.
This is a big ask for Courtney Fry. First time he's been in action since losing in the semi-final of Prize Fighter against Cleverley victim Tony Yoki.
You also get the feeling that Cleverley's a kind of natural athlete. You know, you imagine he'll have tremendous stamina. He's not been called upon too often to use that, but you get that impression.
Yeah, he's young and he's fit and he's full of belief. Good repertoire about him. He hasn't managed to get his timing fully into gear here. Fry hasn't let him, but there's another right over the top, followed by one to the body. He's beginning now to find the range a bit.
Yeah, the worrying thing for Fry, with every round that passes, Cleverley's work is improving a little bit. He's beginning to pin Fry down now and get some more meat into his punches.
Leaning in, okay? M1's,
all right. Well, it was one punch from Cleverley that troubled Fry in this round, Jim.
Yeah, you could see the impact of the punch. Straight away, it was looking to grab. Completely lost himself there. If he could have followed that up, I'm sure he would have scored a knockdown. He got his head cleared, he got himself back into things, but I must identify his confidence.
There's Chelsea star Joe Cole among those enthralled at ringside. Standing room only here tonight in this arena where everybody is a ringside spectator. It's that kind of place. So they keep bringing the boxing back here. Cleverley on top here. Fry with his work cut out, he just has to stay in the fight somehow, you feel, at this stage of things. He'll need more. Fry's record is 13 wins and 2 defeats. He's only fought on average in a 6-year career once every 5 months, and you wonder why a bit, don't you?
Yeah, and I think that's, I mean, when you move in the championship class, that is a problem. I mean, these last couple of fights were only over the 3-round distance as well, remember. But Cleverley is still struggling to pin him down for the powerful shots. So still a bit of work to be done from Cleverley. I mean, I appreciate some of the moves, some of the boxing coming from Fry. He's losing the rounds, he's been outworked, but posing problems. Good work there from him.
Good defence as well, and there's the uppercut from Cleverley, who must feel he's softening up Courtney Fry bit by bit here, but he hasn't quite subdued the spirit yet of Fry, who comes from North London but is based these days in Liverpool, where he works with troubled youngsters.
See, I think this is the kind of fight that Cleverley came in looking for, whereas Fry wanted to box, he wanted to use his skills. So he's the one who is stuck with the task of having to change his plan, and it's not easy.
These left hands to the bodies, they're real crunches, and there's an uppercut as well. All the punches that matter seem to be coming from Nathan Cleverley here. Another right hand gets through. He looks to have the better defence to me as well.
Well, because he's getting his punches off a little bit quicker, he's not allowing Fry to do anything really aggressive. So he's imposing himself and he's taking control. Fry's trying to counter-punch and he's not quick enough to do it.
There's almost a swagger about some of Cleverley's work. He's been blowing away the opposition, really, since that win over Oki, which announced himself to a wider public. He hadn't stopped very many at all until then. In fact, he started off as a 10 stone, 12 pounds light middleweight. He's nearly 2 stone heavier than that now.
Still not able to land full-blooded shots on Fry. That's the fact of Fry's defence is good, his reflexes are good. He's winning the rounds, but not doing any major damage to Fry. So you just wonder, in the later stages, how will this one swing?
Next week, there's an excellent meeting between two terrific experienced campaigners. Jason Booth defending his British Super Bantamweight title against the former champion Michael Hunter. We're live from the Seaburn Centre in Sunderland. Seconds. Friday, October the 16th from 10 p.m. That's over on Sky Sports 1 and HD1.
Round 5!
Back live in the ring here, British and Commonwealth light heavyweight title action, and champion Nathan Cleverley on top so far here. But there's a left hook there from challenger Courtney Fry, and a little smile plays around the lips of Cleverley after that, as if to say, okay, you got me with that one.
Well, a bit of a drive from Fry here. I think he's trying to impose himself. This is what he has to do. He has to change the pattern of what's been taking place. How about his right hand again?
Cracking punch that sent the sweat spraying from the face of Cleverley. This is the best yet from Fry. He needed this. He needed really to win around and establish himself in this argument somehow. Terrific effort from Fry. Can he sustain it? How now does Cleverley respond to that little burst?
Well, Cleverley showed a little bit too much macho there. He got caught with a couple of punches, didn't tighten his defence, got caught with another couple. As though he was trying to show Fry he wasn't impressed, but he wants to tighten up, can't take chances up here at light heavyweight. Everybody can punch.
Good round this for Fry. He's got his jab going to the uppercut. That's troubled him. That really troubled him. The uppercut from Nathan Cleverley. That's turned it a bit in this round. He wilted a bit again there, Jim.
That was a beautiful punch. Cleverley's not a natural powerhouse, but his punches are so well delivered. And that's been his problem so far. Not too many full-blooded shots on target, but that one certainly was.
He's breathing a little more heavily too now, Courtney Fry, I've noticed. Giving away 12 years to the eager Cleverley. Oh, another terrific right uppercut landed there from the Cardiff University student.
Well, he's working the uppercut, doesn't want to overwork it, but delivering it well. I mean, I wonder, has Fry come out with a real effort here to turn things around? And if he doesn't manage it, will his heart begin to dip a little bit? Cleverley really coming back at him now.
Hasn't been able to sustain it, Courtney Fry, after the bright start to the round. Cleverley has kind of said to him, I'm the governor still in there, and he is at the moment, you feel. Good jab that time from Fry. He's having his successes all right.
Well, this is as good as Fry has been so far. He's competing, he's holding his own. Tremendous start to the round. And still getting punches off.
There's that uppercut again, followed by a left hook, a big sliding broadcast, one which missed. Cleverley late in the round, Fry early.
Let's take it again, Kim. Are you alright? You're getting caught with too many shots, alright? Come on now. Are you alright?
Yeah, yeah.
Now listen,
just looking
listen,
for that right every time.
Don't
you cover
get
up.
Complacent. Yeah? You're forgetting your jab.
Okay. I think Cleverley maybe not put enough thought. His defences were atrocious there. And what does he do when he's caught at long range? Leaves his hands down and he's caught again at long range. So I'm sure he'll be getting a telling off in the corner at this moment. He pulled himself together, landed some lovely uppercuts as the round was wearing on. But again, Courtney Fry came back at him. But was that the big drive from Courtney Fry, or can he come back out and give us another one?
Cleverley's now 25-1 on, having started at 12-1 on.
Corners, 10 seconds.
The bookmakers have made up their minds which way this is going, all right. Fry a measly 8-1 against. Where the bookmakers. Sixth round, the yellow and black of Nathan Cleverley. He might be the only professional boxer out there in the world at the moment who can handle quadratic equations. Knows the angles in there as well too, doesn't he?
A couple of little reminders that Cleverley still has a few things to learn. I mean, I knew Fry was the cutest opponent he'd faced. He's missing badly at times, and when he's not dominating, when he's having to solve things out, you think that would be strength, but at times it's not.
He waited Fry, and Cleverley came back with a jab this time. Big advantage in speed, you feel, for the youngster. Speed and power, I reckon, as well. Fry needs to try to somehow outbox him, otherwise how does he win this?
Well, Fry's trying to come forward, and I think that's a good plan. You have to take some of the momentum out of Cleverley's work. Good left hook from Cleverley. I mean, he's the only one who's been landing the hurtful punches tonight. He's shaken Fry up a few times. They're not landing cleanly with full-blooded shots as often as they would like, I'm sure.
There's talk of a European title fight coming up for Nathan Cleverley if he wins this tonight. He's certainly winning it at the moment. It might be as early as December the 5th, we're hearing. The Viking title against Antonio Brancaleone, the Italian. Just pouring with the jab, Fry. No ramrod quality about it.
I think he's just trying to prevent Cleverley from getting anything off. Some of the jabs he's throwing, he knows they're out of range, but he's stopping Cleverley from setting anything up. Cleverley's winning this round, but I don't feel he's finding the smoothness that we usually see from him. Hasn't solved Fry out. Have to give Fry a lot of credit for the problems that he's posing.
Little marked up around the face, Courtney Fry. Little more ragged in this round though is Cleverley.
No, he was struggling with the fact that Fry is such a good boxer who's thinking his way around what he's doing, who's not making the mistakes that Cleverley is so used to pouncing on in his previous fights. Finding it tough to draw mistakes from Fry.
Quiet around that one. Backstage, and still to come live tonight, Billy Joe Saunders, the Olympian who's unbeaten so far as a pro, 3 out of 3. He's in action against Alex Spitko, and that's what he thinks about this one.
Every time I've got in the ring now, I mean, I feel them out the first round. I always do, even as amateur, I always feel them out the first round and go to work on the second. And that's what I've been doing, and I've been stopping them every time in the second. So I'm not looking for the stoppage or anything. I'm just going to go there, me boxing head on me, and this, like I say, adapt to the professional style and use me boxing skills. And if it comes, it's come. It's come 3 times, so can't see why not a fourth.
He's looked exciting so far, getting ready, warming up with Jimmy Tibbs, the trainer there in the dressing room. Billy Joe Saunders, his style very well suited to the pros, it could seem. Seventh round of this one. It was a pretty quiet sixth.
I'm enjoying this one because there's two guys who really know their way around a boxing ring. A good solid jab from Cleverley. Not been able to land too many of those. He doesn't have the confidence to step right in with the punches. Because Fry has been dipping. A good shot again, caught him a little bit high. But again, you just saw the legs reacting.
They're hoping in Wales that Nathan Cleverley might turn out to be a new Joe Calzaghe for them. And of course those two are pretty close friends and have sparred together a lot. Joe's retired now, got one or two other things on his mind, as you may have seen in the newspapers. Fry needs to put some rounds in the bank, doesn't he, on the scorecard?
He's not doing enough to win the rounds. That's his problem. He's causing all sorts of problems from Cleverley. I don't think Cleverley's enjoying this too much. He's not out jabbing. He's not landing his own punches solidly. As I say, posing problems, but not doing enough to win the battle.
Using his experience, Courtney Fry, to frustrate Cleverley at times in this, and not let have things all his own way in the contest. Just gone a little quieter, Cleverley, over the last couple of rounds. And credit to Courtney Fry for sticking in there with this, but now he has to go about the job of clawing back what must be a fairly sizable deficit, I would say.
I think Cleverley appreciates the fact that if he does silly things, he's going to be punished for it. So he's really thinking his way around now. He's not committing himself, he's not taking chances. You know, you can see he's not just throwing wild punches the way he was in the opening round. He just come out and set a pace without thinking. But he's been clipped a few times with counters, so now Cleverley has realised he has to think what he's doing here.
Tribute to the conditioning of Courtney Fry, who said he had about a month to get himself ready for this. He's been using all kinds of sparring partners of different height. I think he knows this is his final chance. By the way, it's his first chance too as a pro. That's the way his pro career has been.
See, that's the difference again. Cleverley's the one who's prepared to put punches together. He's been one for a low punch, but I mean, it's they haven't been too many landing low, thankfully. But he's the one who's prepared just to pump the extra punches out to make sure he's winning the rounds.
Let's have a look at some of the men who've held this famous title down the years. And there are some very, very big names. Len Harvey, who man and child fought at just about every weight. One of the legends of British boxing, world champion as well, Freddie Mills, one of the great charismatic men just after the war. Randolph Turpin, with that famous win over Sugar Ray Robinson, that of course was at middleweight, he didn't go up to light heavy. That was in the 1950s. The late, sadly late, Chris Finnegan, marvellous boxer, Olympic gold medalist as well. John Conte, a beautiful operator, beating Jorge Ahumada for the world championship, and Crawford Ashley in more recent times from Leeds. Real character Clinton Round Woods as well, went on to be world champion. So some big names there, and Cleverley is the latest holder. He's ahead here, no doubt about that, but over the last couple of rounds he's put in his least two impressive shifts of the contest perhaps, Jim.
Yep, and listening to his corner in between rounds, they know this job is far from over. I mean, Fry is more than capable. He's matching cleverly with the jab. You can see my points, I have him comfortably in front. They're still having to work every second to keep things that way, and I think his corner agree with that.
Cleverley's been having things much his own way in his career over the last year or so, but Courtney Fry putting in a respectable effort tonight, whether it's conceivably a winning effort has to be very, very doubtful at this stage of the game. Needs more than he's coming up with so far.
Fry just needs to come up himself a little bit more, try and impose himself.
Cleverley's gone a little negative over the last two sessions, not doing so much, not even throwing out his jab. Is he just having a little breather in the middle of rounds here, thinking he's got things in the bank?
I don't think it's the first time he's been in the ring with someone who's as smart as he is. He's not as young, not as lively, but he's every bit as smart, and he knows if he makes mistakes. You can see him, the jab's landing short, he's not putting punches together. He should be dubbing the jab, moving in behind it. He's just a little bit tentative himself, and when you're throwing tentative punches at such a good counter puncher, you're never going to land cleanly. So lots of problems, and if Fry just put a little bit more into this, he could certainly tighten things up. Maybe if he committed himself more, then maybe that would suit cleverly. I don't know. This is good stuff to watch.
Left hand there. Just marked up around the left eye, Courtney Frye. I think the question with him here, Jim, is he here just to put in a good, respectable effort as a big outsider against Cleverley, or is he here really to steal this championship away?
But Ian, he's doing a lot better than I thought he would have done. I thought by this time, you know, Cleverley would be dominating. Well, he's not dominating. He's still having a lot of shots.
He's dominating with that one. Big right hand. He's all over the place here. He might go. Tottering, nearly went down. Cleverley fancies he might finish it. Uppercut, trying to pick the shots. Body punch as well. He's having to suck it up, Frye. More punches raining in. The referee's going to dive in here. It is over. Courtney Frye collapses as well. The fight had already been stopped. And Nathan Cleverley opened up and won it very, very impressively in the end. Frye did his best. He frustrated Cleverley for a while. But the youngster at the moment is really on a roll, and there's no stopping him.
Yeah, well, that's what being a champion is all about. When things are not going as easily as you would like them to, when things are not falling into place, you have just to dig in and grind out the performance. And that was a tremendous finish. He just showed his class at long last. It was a little bit of a struggle, so full credit to Courtney Frye. Bit of a tremendous show. He was never winning the fight, certainly not in my card. But posed all sorts of problems for Cleverley. So I think Cleverley's grown up tonight. But maybe a little reminder that he still has things to learn in this business. He's not the finished article just yet. But you can see, you can see the experience here of his championship boxing. He wasn't allowing Frye to spoil here, giving himself room, getting the punches off, full power behind them, not missing any, and forcing referee Lachlan to step in and finish it.
Tell you what I liked about this, Jim. Once he had him going, the finishing was clinical.
Yeah, that's what I liked about him too. You know, he didn't allow Frye to spoil, to grab hold, to survive. He gave himself punching room and he placed every punch, whether it be to the body, to the head, and didn't stop throwing the punches. Referee timed it nicely, but the momentum of Frye going over pulled him down.
Wasn't impressive all the way through, but I think you saw enough there to realise that Nathan Cleverley is going to be, I think, a world-class light heavyweight for us. He's still unbeaten now in 18 contests. He's now stopped his last five, and a European title shot beckons for him maybe as early as December.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 2 minutes 51 seconds of round 8, your referee, Victor Lachlan, has stopped the contest. He deemed that Courtney Frye was in no position to continue. The winner and still the British and Commonwealth light heavyweight champion, Nathan Cleverley. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the gallant and brave Courtney Frye.
We'll be talking to a delighted Nathan Cleverley after the break. Nicky Piper will be giving his marks out of 10. There's a special report from the training camp of the huge WBA heavyweight champion Nikolai Valuev. Plus, next up, the second of our...
Well, Nathan, a spectacular ending, but was that quite a tough night's work?
It was tough, and I was under no illusions. You know, I knew Courtney Frye was going to be a tough fight. He had a great amateur pedigree, and as you could see, he was a very good boxer. Nice on the jab. Nice on his legs, but I showed a different kind of fight tonight. Instead of going out muscling on Courtney Frye, I decided to keep it long, tip away with a jab, wait for the big right hand, and he come in round 9. Was it round 9?
You seemed to change tactics a bit during the fight. What kind of worked and what didn't?
I think it's important now that, you know, I show all aspects of my game. You know, we're talking, myself and Frank, we're going to sit down, we're talking about bigger and better things, European titles. And potentially, you know, I'm going to be world champion. So it's important that I show all sides of my boxing game. You know, that I can box, that I can fight, that I can take a shot. And I think I've shown that now in my 18 fights.
You've been nominated now to fight for the European title, Motor Fight One. What's the latest with that? What's the latest with the European title?
We're trying to get it done for the 5th of December, and we're working on it. But it's not done yet, so it may go to Persepolis. We're not sure yet, but whatever happens, obviously we're going to be looking for the home advantage for Nathan.
Antonio Brancaleone's is the co-challenger. He's from Italy. Would you go to Italy?
Yeah, of course. You know, I'll go anywhere and fight. It's what I love doing. Nothing phases me really in the boxing ring. I just go in, enjoy myself, but I make sure I win, you know, and I got to win and I got to look good winning. And I think I've displayed that in my last six fights.